So, recently, me and Ali had the opportunity to get away on our own for a couple of nights. I was at university, so he was away that weekend himself, and Emma was away at our weekend with Popwood Hall College. So we booked a nice glamp cabin just outside Scarborough on the East Coast. What we didn't know when booking was that Storm Arwen had also booked in that same weekend. Nice to be with her. And on the way to the East Coast, we listened to a podcast. It was an interview by Gary Chapman. Some of you will have heard of Gary Chapman. He wrote The Five Love Languages. And he was interviewing a lady who had written an Advent devotional based on the songs in the first Christmas story. One of which was Mary's song, known now as the Magnificat, found in Luke 1. The lady went on to compare the response of Mary that first Christmas to the response of Eve in the story of Genesis. See, Luke 1, an angel appears to Mary. Now, if that's not enough, and that doesn't happen every day, the angel tells her that she has found favour with God. The angel goes on to tell her that she will become pregnant with a son, though she's not yet married. She will give him the name Jesus, that he will be great, that he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end. Now, this is some encounter in itself, isn't it? This angel appears to Mary and just gives her this news that she will be pregnant and her baby is going to be this, well, amazing. His kingdom will never end. But perhaps for me, one of the most amazing things is actually Mary's response. In verse 38, it says, "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." To me, that is a wow verse in the Bible. When Mary is told this news about this from this angel and what's going to happen, and she just simply said, "I am the Lord's servant. Mary, your word, may your word be fulfilled with me." Wow. She then goes on to sing this amazing song, which we now know as the Magnificat. Let me just read some of the words that Mary sings. But we talk about it now as a song. "My soul glorifies the Lord," she says, "and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. For he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed. For the mighty one has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him from generation to generation. He has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in the utmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones. He has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things. He has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, even as he said to our fathers." It's a song. It's Mary's response to this news of the angel. You know, I think this response tells us a lot about Mary. It tells us a lot about her character. It tells us a lot about her heart. Mary is not just a young girl dressed in blue in a nativity play. She is a person of humility. She is a person of obedience. She is a person of worship, a person of devotion. A woman of faith who is prepared to follow her God with everything. Now, like I said, in the podcast that we listened to on our way to Storm Arwen, the woman gave the contrast of Mary's response in the Christmas story to Eve's response in the Garden of Eden. Eve had been given everything in the Garden of Eden. Everything that she needed by God. But she was tempted away to choose the one thing that had been forbidden. Eve chose not to follow God's best, not to follow God's will, but instead her self-nature. This contrast, in some ways, could also be made between Joseph that first Christmas and Adam, along with Eve, in the Garden of Eden. See, after an angel appeared to Joseph with the news about Mary, we read his response, Matthew 1, verse 24. When Joseph woke up, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son, and they gave him the name Jesus. Yet in Genesis, we read that Adam, like Eve, chose to disobey God. He chose self. You know, if I had more time, I would have looked at some of the consequences of the choices that they made, both Mary and Joseph, both Adam and Eve. I haven't. But on this Christmas day, this choice, I believe, echoes to us. The choice is my way, self, or God's way, which is about surrender. It's about going after the riches of this world, worldly gain, or going after the riches of the kingdom of heaven, peace, joy, hope, forgiveness, love. It's about seeking after the things of man or seeking first the kingdom of God. Ultimately, it's about accepting Jesus or rejecting Jesus. So this picture, just saw it on somebody's Facebook post, and I screenshotted it, and I quite liked it, but the picture down. There you go. And there you see a guy, don't you, he seems to be trapped in prison, and there's kind of a choice, and he's reaching out for the bread, which person put the word next to it, world. Well, on the other side, there's a key. Somebody's put the word Jesus there. I think that's a really good picture for me, because the bread meets a need for a time. But the key sets you free for all time. Thanks, Dad. Another illustration for me is in what songs people choose for their final funeral song. Yeah, that's it. Keep it light, David. For me, one of the best I've heard, because obviously I take funeral services, and one of the best ones for me, someone went out to Nelly the Elephant. But actually, for the person it was appropriate. It was his nickname. But I once read that one of the top choices for people's final or song that they go out to for their funeral is the song My Way by Frank Sinatra. The lyrics say this: for what is man, what has he got? If not himself, then he has not. Not to say the things that he truly feels, and not the words of someone who kneels. The records show I took all the barrels and I did it my way. Some will know the song that I've chosen for my funeral. Now some definitely will know the song that I've chosen for my funeral. Hopefully not just yet. But I've chosen the song Only Jesus by Casting Crowns. I've read the lyrics out before. Some of them say this: and I don't want to leave a legacy. I don't care if they remember me, only Jesus. And I've only got one life to live, and I'll let every second point to him. Only Jesus. You know, it's the ultimate choice. It's the Matrix red or blue pill moment. It's the choice. You know, back in the 80s, there used to be a t-shirt made famous by Wham with the slogan, "Choose life." Many of you will remember it. It's funny to me how Moses in Exodus gave the same slogan to the Israelites thousands of years before WOW ever existed. You know, I believe choosing life is choosing the Christ of Christmas. Not just once, not just on his birthday, but as a daily choice. As a daily choice. As a daily choice. As a daily choice. So this Christmas, to the ladies in the house, will you be like Mary, or will you be like Eve? To all the men in the house, will we be like Joseph, or will we be like Adam? Me or him? Mine or yours? The broad path or the narrow path? Death or life? Self or Saviour? I pray that we all make the right choice. Not just today, but every day.
See you.